shifting. It makes you feel happy like a good nail peeling. I'll tell you about the magic, it'll free your soul. But it's like trying to tell a stranger about the hollow. Yes, hollow. Sorry to all the new people. Well, hello everyone, it's me, Christine, again, and I've got an actual nail polish video for you today, wow. But this isn't just any regular nail polish, no. Now, we've all seen multichrome nail polish, right? It's made up of pigments that shift all the way from one color to another depending on what angle you look at it. But have you ever seen a nail polish do this? Yeah, that's right, it's a magnet, and there's tiny bits of magnetic particles in this actual nail polish. These are new multi-chrome magnetic polishes by Fun Lacquer. You may have seen these nails before in one of my LA vlogs that I posted a couple months ago on my second channel. I got so many comments asking me what the hell was on my nails, and I'm so sorry it took me this long, but I'm finally getting around to showing you. You guys know that I love and use a lot of Fun Lacquer polishes, and I do have my own collaboration collection with them. But this video is not sponsored. I do have an affiliate code you can use at Fun Lacquer to save some money if you wish. It's simply Big Surprise. But I was not paid to make this specific video. I just chose to because this stuff is f***ing mesmerizing and it deserves its own video. Okay, so magnetic polish. What the hell does that mean? And how the f*** does it work? There are little bits of metal shavings in the nail polish itself, possibly made of iron. When you put a strong magnet near the polish, the metal particles are attracted to the magnet, so they pull in tight along the magnet. That's why, depending on the shape of the magnet, you can get different designs. It's kind of like what happens when you put a magnet near metal objects in life. Like a magnet to the fridge, they stick together. Only with the polish, the metal shavings are tiny and get stuck in the weight of the other ingredients in the nail polish so they don't actually burst up out of your nail and right up onto the magnet. That would be pretty insane, actually. The magnet just pulls the metal shavings towards its center directly beneath it within the nail polish. Pretty cool, eh? How's that for some simply science logical? And it's a damn strong magnet, okay? Like, you do not want to mess with this. It has a super strong pull and sticks to basically anything metal, so I would be very cautious slinging it around before it becomes a lethal weapon. This magnetic multichrome collection was released about a month ago, but it sold out pretty much immediately, but it is finally back in stock. Yay! So the magnet wand has two different sized heads. Sounds scary, I know. There's a rectangular one, which kind of makes a linear stripe through the polish, and then there's a circle one that you can use to make more kind of swirly designs. Okay, let's play. So I'm gonna show you on a swatch stick first because we're gonna do some experiments, of course. It applies just like normal multi-chrome polish, so you'd apply just one coat and don't bother with the magnet yet. And then you would apply a more generous second coat so that there's more magnetic pigments to be pulled by the magnet. And then pretty much immediately, while the polish is still wet, you're gonna take the magnet and hold it just above the nail. Don't push it into the nail because then you'll just ruin it. But it's very important that you hold the magnet still in the same position for at least 15 to 30 seconds. And holy shit. This shit is mind-blowing. Look how 3D that looks. Bam. Gorgeous. Okay, let's try out another shade. This one's a purple to kind of teal green multichrome, so you're getting a different spectrum of the color wheel. As you can see, I'm holding the magnet kind of sideways, so I'm getting this kind of diagonal stripe across the nail, but you could do it straight down the nail, horizontally or vertically, it's all up to you. If you're doing a third coat, I would suggest holding the magnet in the exact same spot and direction as you did after you did the second coat, just so the pattern is consistent on all layers. And finally, we got this multichrome shade, which shifts from kind of an olive green to a burnt coppery red color. Beautiful. This one looks kind of vintage chic, you know? So there's two reasons why this polish is so magical. The first is this kind of 3D effect you get from the magnetic pigments being pulled together in one spot on the nail, and then as you shift the angle of your nails, it looks like that line is moving. It's crazy. The second reason why this polish is so magical is that in addition to being magnetic, it's also multichrome, which means depending on the angle you're looking at your nail and the light source, the colors actually shift too. So the nail can go from looking like one solid color to having a range of colors, or to really just show the color on the far end of its multichrome spectrum. If you don't like the straight line look, you can use the circular magnet to make the design look more S-shaped. You do have to be aware though that once you start pulling the magnetic pigments in from one side in the nail, it might affect how the other side of the nail looks. I also want to note that I found the initial tightness of the magnetic pole softened after 20 minutes or so, as if some of the magnetic pigments in the polish slowly dissipated a bit outwards from where they were initially pulled to. For this reason, I think it's important to hold the magnet for the longer end of the suggested 15 to 30 second time range, or even longer than that. Now, you might be asking yourself the question, can you use any magnet? Benji had the same question, so I thought I'd try it out. And the answer is, no. A regular fridge magnet will not work. There's something about these specialized magnets that are super powerful, so it's really gonna pull those pigments together. But hey, I mean, if you have a super powerful magnet that's very narrow in shape at home, then that might work. For those of you who are super hardcore in the nail polish world, you may remember that a few years ago, especially on Instagram, this Russian brand named Mazura came out with these magnetic polishes that were blowing everyone's mind. They actually sent me a bunch of these a long time ago, and I just never got around to using them, but here we are. I was curious how they compared to the Fun Lacquer ones, so I did a bunch of swatches, and from what I can tell, none of the Mazura ones, at least that I have or I have seen, are multichrome, meaning that they don't shift between different hues of color. They are just straight up magnetic polishes with one color pigment. I would say after swatching a bunch of these Mazura magnetic polishes, I'm more impressed by the Fun Lacquer ones because they are also multichrome, and it just makes it so much more extra, exactly the way I like my nails. And you know what's even more extra? Adding a holo taco. Oh shit. Oh my god. And here you go, the easiest DIY galaxy nail tutorial ever. Menchie is impressed. Menchie is very impressed, everyone. So this was a holo flaky top coat, which is a very asymmetrical kind of scattered holo look. So let's also try out a linear holo taco. Oops, we got a Menchie here. And with that, you get a pretty even distribution of holo over top, giving the nail a very different appearance than with a scattered holo. And lastly, I tried a scattered, very tiny holo glitter taco. Again, easiest galaxy nail in the universe. But now let's step it up to the next level of extra and add some super chunky, loose holo flakies. I'm gonna add a gel taco first, bake that shit for a minute. And oh, wait a second. What's on my other hand? It's one of these Fun Lacquer magnetic polishes, but this is when I was first practicing, so the magnetic design is not as good looking. Practice makes perfect. So I put on a gel taco because I find that these holo flakes stick best to that. And you just want to buff in a couple so you don't completely cover up the beautiful polish underneath, but just enough so it looks out of this damn world. I like this combination so much that that's exactly how I did my nails before I went to LA, just with a different shade of the magnetic polish underneath. And I even recorded it. Let me show you step by step. Peel off base coat, because there will be peel porn. One very thin coat of the magnetic polish, no need to use the magnet yet. And like I said, most multichrome polishes are very sheer, so you're gonna need 2 to 3 coats to build up opacity, so this is quite normal. After it dries, add a second very generous coat of the magnetic polish, and then you gotta work quickly, and before it dries, grab your special magnet, and then hold it over the nail in the exact same position, try not to move, for at least 15 to 30 seconds. Move the magnet away, and wow, beautiful. But as you can see, it's still very sheer in the spots that the magnet was not targeting. So we're gonna do a third coat and repeat. Like, how fucking cool is that? Sometimes I wonder to myself, does anyone get as excited as I do about these things? Because I could stare at nails that shift like this all day. And then next, because I can't help myself, I added a nice thick coat of glassy gel taco. You don't have to use gel, you could just use a regular top coat for this. Bake that shit for a minute. And then I gently buffed in some loose holo flakes using a makeup sponge, but not too much because I didn't want to cover up the whole magical design underneath. If you do this with a regular glossy taco, you probably wouldn't want to use a makeup sponge because it'll just cause a bunch of spongy dents in the top of your nail, but you could kind of lightly dust on the flakies by dropping them on top of your nail. Oh my god, stunning. Then I seal it all in with a final coat of glossy gel taco. Bake that shit for a minute one more time. And I have to say that these are some of the easiest nails you can do yourself that people will think were really complicated to do or must have been done by a professional in a salon. When I first tried out the magnet on my other hand, I struggled a little bit with the idea of holding the magnet in the same spot for 15 to 30 seconds. Once you figure that part out, you're good. It's not that complicated. I don't know what my problem was. I think this magnetic multi-chrome polish looks so stunning on its own. Or you can be super creative and extra like me and try it out with all different types of hollow tacos. All right, well, that's that. Let me know in the comments if you guys are as impressed and shocked at this shit as I am. I'll put a link to where you can find this polish down below in the video description box. And don't forget, you can use my affiliate code Simply to save some money. I think it's a win-win when you do, because I get some money and you save some money, because we all saving up to buy more holo. All right, guys, what do you say? I think it's time for some peel porn. Ooh. Not only are you seeing my naked nails, but these peelies are just so damn sexy. I wouldn't be surprised if YouTube decided to demonetize this video. Oh, these will look so good in my peely bank. Alright guys, as always, thanks so much for watching and I'll see y'all later, bye! Thank you.